good morning. When Anne asked me to talk today, I started thinking, what can I talk about? I will be after Telefonica, after Deutsche, after Telenor, everything will be said, difficult to find anything new. And quite frankly, I have also been here a number of times, so I said, also difficult to say something new again. So I thought that maybe the good thing to do would be to share not the view of an operator and pretend not to be an operator for 15 minutes, but share the view of the customers and what, based on our research, our contact with the customers, our focus groups, our meetings, whatever, share what the customers are telling us about our industry and what is really important for them. And yes, I am a customer, Frederick, because unlike you, I didn't turn off my phones. I keep using them and I keep texting during speeches, and it works very well. So, congratulations. So, first of all, what do I, as a European customer, I apologize, I talk more as a European customer here. First of all, I'm confused. I am bombarded by messages. I'm bombarded by 4G, 5G, net neutrality, oh, Snowden, security, privacy, cyber stuff, roaming, roaming costs, roaming should disappear, new European connected continent, and then digital India. So I hear a lot of people who are talking on my behalf, on the behalf of the customer. So I don't understand all these things. What is really important to me? Now, let me share what, based on what we hear from customers, market research, and things like that, what is really important for me. In real order of priority, I have to be honest, the first four things is really what we get from the customers. The fifth is shaping up, is not yet there, but I sense it is also coming. So first of all, customers tell us that after so many years, they really want quality, and they are happy. I am happy as a customer. Finally, with 4G, I'm getting speed. This morning coming here, I got 60 megabit per second. In this room, while Frederick was talking, I got 90 megabit per second. The average is not 90, of course it's not. It's 18, 15, 17. But finally, after all talk, this industry, the telecommunication industry, is giving me what I really need: speed and connectivity. And it's becoming really ubiquitous. 70% coverage, going up to 90 in a couple of years, I hear. Finally, I can really do what this industry has been promising, quite frankly, over-promising. If I'm a customer, I think we have over-promised for a few years, but now it's here. And I'm using it a lot. I'm using data 2 to 3 times more than 1 year ago, not more than 10 years ago. Now data is going up, my usage is liberated. Now, is it liberated for what? And this is interesting, because everybody, including Tim Höttges, who spoke before me, is honest. Tim, when he had to give the priority, said, first we shared motions, and then you added, and then, of course, our business applications. This is exactly what is happening. Even business users use data a lot for their personal usage, for emotions, for entertainment. Entertainment is becoming, has a new spring, a new age. And there's a lot of usage which is going into video, into music, and into a lot of things. But one thing which is very important as a customer, and this is a bit contrary to the public perception, there's much more media usage. There's been a lot of talk that the media industry was dead. There was a lot of talk that people would not use and look at content. It's not true. I, as a customer, use more, read more, get more news. And to be honest, it's not just an Anglo-Saxon thing. People say, yeah, sure, English is the most spoken language in the world, therefore, by definition, you know, the English content will go everywhere. And of course, some, you know, media outlets are finding fantastic worldwide distribution. But even, you know, I put an example there, even from my country, even a country whose language is spoken only essentially in one country, usage is growing because of digital. And it's not just traditional usage, it's video. Video is becoming very important. The example here is, you know, a company I was associated with for a while, actually seeing total readership going up, even if old readership goes down, total readership goes up and video go up. So as a customer, I'm happy. I finally can get what I want, where I want. And of course, yes, I do use it a lot for business, but essentially, I use it for my life. So first thing, as a customer, all market research says, I want more of this. I want more investment. I want more infrastructure. I want more speed. I want more ubiquity. And this is very important that policymakers remember, because this is the first request of customers. The second one is price. Now, as a customer, I want good prices. I think in Europe I'm getting good prices. This is a Eurostat statistics that says that in the last 8-9 years, the only service that has been deflationary is communications. And actually, this is the experience I have as a customer. When I'm in London, if I have to give to my son a SIM card with data, with SMS, with minutes, I spend probably £15, maybe 17, depending on how much data I want to give. And that's much less than in the US. In the US, it would be the same number, $50, $60, $70. So in Europe, as a customer, I'm starting to see that price is a little bit less important than the real strong beauty of the access to data. Now, are we perfect? No, I don't think we are. I'm really annoyed by data roaming. I'm annoyed when I have to pay €3 per megabyte, including to Vodafone sometimes. I don't think why my newspaper that is 30, 40 megabytes, I should pay €90 when I'm in Morocco or in China or in Indonesia. I think it's completely crazy. And I understand, as a customer, that roaming cannot be completely the same everywhere. I understand a taxi in Dusseldorf or in Luxembourg costs a little bit different than a taxi in Athens, even if the car is the same. But I cannot pay this type of prices. But on the other hand, I'm also happier now, and this starts to show in the customer results, in the fact that I can start roaming like at home. This is a Vodafone statistics, clearly. One third of the customers now take their own tariffs abroad. I can use data in a more freely way, in a more free way, and I can start not be too worried by the cost of this. And this means that sometimes I, as it was said by my previous speaker, sometimes I use Wi-Fi, sometimes I don't, because the quality is better on my normal network and because I already have access to a great tariff. So price is still important. I still declare it's the second priority as a customer, but it's not as bad as I thought it was. And it's still some work to do, but I'm getting a better deal over time. Third thing that I declare always as a customer in my research, in my this story about privacy and security. Now, this is very annoying for me as a customer. Everybody tries to say that privacy is more important than security, or security is more important than privacy. As a customer, I want both. I want privacy and security. It's a very delicate thing. I'm confused as a customer. I read, for example, that Facebook is used by jihadists to do recruitment or dissemination of bad stuff. Do I like it? No. Do I really want Facebook to become a policeman, as somebody is advocating? I don't think I want. As a customer, I want these guys to continue to give service. I also hear that encryption is coming to my Gmail. Actually, has come to my Gmail, to my Facebook, to my FaceTime. Do I like it? Of course I like it. I like that my communication is kept private. But I'm concerned. I don't want the same guys to use encryption to then blow me up or blow my children up when I'm in a supermarket or in a public space. So on this privacy versus security thing, I'm sorry, as a citizen, as a European citizen, I declare I want both. And I, back to the point of trust that was raised before, I don't see why Europe should not be able to find a solution in this space. The solution has always been there. Telecommunication companies have always given the good balance of privacy and security. This has to be guaranteed in a data world. Otherwise, I will start as a consumer to feel uncomfortable with one of the two dimensions. It's very important. It's not as important as quality of network and price, but it's important that in the data world, both of them are guaranteed. Fourth thing, I want to continue to have choice. Now, when Tim Höttges, when Vittorio Colao, when Cesar Alierta do their market research on their brands, they always ask me first, do you like more Telefonica, Vodafone, Deutsche Telekom, then Facebook, Google, this and that? And I'm sorry, I always answer the truth. And the truth is, I love Google, I love Amazon, I love Facebook, because they're brilliant services. because they work very well for me. Because they give me, I mean, this is what customers seriously tell us in the market research, because they give me a better life. But I'm not, as a customer, a fool. I understand that these guys control 96% of my life. I mean, two companies control the operating system. I understand that all of my data goes into Google, 92% of the search. I understand that there is a strong dominance in the distribution of books and digital content on guys. And Facebook will control more than a billion of the communication, you know, connections. So on one hand, I like this, and to be honest, I'm continuing to use it, but I want to be able to choose. And as it was said by Cesar in the opening speech, we start seeing that some customers start questioning why there is no portability of digital life. Why do I have to pay two times for the same app because these are two operating systems? And why can I not be protected, or at least can I not know exactly what's happening with my data? It's too concentrated in one place. So on one hand, as a customer, when I declare whether I like or not those brands, I do like those brands. Of course I like, they're great. But I also want to be able to continue to choose. I want to be able to port my digital life everywhere else. As much as in the telecommunication space, I want to continue to be able to choose. In the mobile world, it was great. I can choose operators. I can change operators. Maybe sometimes Vittorio Colao, the CEO, not Vittorio Colao, the customer would say customers change operators a bit too much. But hey, as a customer, I was happy to change in the mobile world. I want to be able to continue to choose also in the fixed broadband world, in this converged new world. In the converged new world, changing fixed provider, broadband provider should be as easy and not obstructed as in the fixed world, because competition and choice are good. Are good for the OTTs, are good also for us. And then there is a fifth thing that as a customer I keep hearing and I express my opinion, and I have to say here, outside of the joke, of the customer metaphor, here customers are shaping their thinking. This net neutrality discussion, there is one thing that comes out of research always. Customers hate the idea that any site could be discriminated, the idea that any site can be blocked, that any site can be slowed down. And in that sense, if that is net neutrality, customers who don't fully get what is net neutrality, they say, of course I'm in favor of net neutrality. But we, as Vodafone, did a research recently asking youth and people around many countries, what do you really fear and what do you want from the digital world? And yes, they want unrestricted access, but they are also very aware that there is a fantastic world out there, the world of the driverless cars, the world of the intelligent buildings, the world of smart logistics and automated deliveries, the drones coming from Amazon's, all the nice things that cannot, as Tim Höttges said before, cannot be completely put into a complete neutrality space. So the one request that comes from customers is, yes, non-discrimination, super strong, high priority, but also create the new industrial world of the future, the new society of the future, jobs, employment, investment. And this is, again, not completely clear, which is why probably the policymakers also have a little bit of difficulty in framing this issue. But it is coming up, and especially in Europe, there is a strong perception that with more investment in infrastructure, with more quality, good affordable prices, and choice and competition, actually the opportunity for research, environment, employment, and most important, a better life for the new generation actually can be delivered by the digital world. This is what comes out mostly of our research. As I say, four things very clear: quality, speed, delivery, price, security and privacy, not security or privacy, and choice and competition. And then the fifth one, which is non-discrimination, but also enabling all the services of the future, which are coming mostly as an opportunity for employment and entrepreneurship. This is what customers tell us. I'm very curious to discuss with my colleagues what we think about it.